तो गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडे लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फ्यूल सेल एंड फ्यूल सेल पावर प्लांट। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ फ्यूल सेल। इन दैट केस वी ऑल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट अल्कलाइन फ्यूल सेल। इन टुडेज लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू ब्रीफ डिस्कशन अबाउट फॉस्फोरिक एसिड फ्यूल सेल एंड अल्कलाइन फ्यूल सेल ओनली, एंड देन वी विल डिस्कस द fuel cell power plant. Okay, so in the last lecture we have discussed that according to electrolyte used, fuel cell cells can be classified as phosphoric acid fuel cell, alkaline fuel cell, polymer electric membrane fuel cell, molten carbonate fuel cell, and solid oxide fuel cell. So the description of or operation of fuel cell almost remains the same. They are like the difference in electrolyte used and small construction of the fuel cell only. So you can see alkaline fuel cell, we discussed this yesterday also in the previous lecture. So it is made up of two electrodes, and between these two electrodes are porous, and in between these two electrodes electrolyte is there. In case of alkaline fuel cell, the electrolyte used is aqueous sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide to certain concentration, and these electrodes are made up of metal like nickel, and in order to increase the rate of reaction of fuel, electrolyte and the electrode, generally these should be made up of platinum. But is from the point of view of cost, platinum is very costly, that's why these are made up of nickel, and these are porous so that the gas hydroxyl ions can move from this side to this side. When we supply hydrogen, it acts as a fuel by the reaction which takes place at the electrode. Electrons are emitted from this hydrogen, and protons, that means H plus ion, moves from this side to this side. It reacts with the oxygen which is supplied from this end of the fuel cell, and it makes water, H2O. When the fuel cell operates, due to the chemical reaction taking place inside it, certain heat is also generated. So since we want to generate continuous amount of electricity, and that electricity is caused by the movement of the electrons which are emitted by this hydrogen only, and hydroxyl ions reacts with oxygen and makes water. So water and heat is available in it, which has to be drawn continuously from the fuel cell. So in this figure you can see that water is taken out. Water, apart from water, heat is also taken out from this fuel cell. Alkaline fuel cells use an aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide as the electrolyte. The fuel is hydrogen gas or hydrogen rich gas, and oxidizing agent is the oxygen. It can be air, ambient air can also be used for this purpose. Electrodes are made up of carbon and metals such as nickel. Fuel cells generally operate at less than 100 degrees centigrade and are constructed of metal and certain plastic. This is about its body. If you see in this figure, in order to keep these electrolyte in place here, we have to make the body, and that is made up of either plastic or of some metal. Water as a reaction product is removed from the system. So as I told you earlier, that when we supply the hydrogen from this side to the fuel cell, then electrochemical reaction between this gas, hydrogen, this electrode and electrolyte takes place, and hydrogen emits electrons and protons move to this side because this electrode is porous. The arrangement is such that electrons cannot move from this side to this side, so electrons travels from this electrode through this load to this terminal, and due to it, if we apply certain load, then electricity flows from this load also. Okay, so water as a reaction agent is removed from the, due to this action, water is produced which has to be removed continuously if we want to produce electricity continuously using this fuel cell. The strong hot alkaline electrolyte attacks most plastics and tend to penetrate structural seams and joints. This problem has been overcome. However, alkaline fuel cells are used in the US space shuttle orbiters, and overall efficiencies range from 0.3 to 0.8, that is 30 to 80% depending upon fuel and oxidizer. So if we use pure hydrogen and pure oxygen, then in that case, the efficiency will be higher. And if we use hydrogen rich gas or MNT, in that case, it will be lower. So this was the working of alkaline fuel cell. Now we move on to the phosphoric acid fuel cell, that is PAFC. So you can see the figure. Figure is almost similar, which was shown previously in case of alkaline fuel cell. There are two electrodes which are porous, and these can be made up of certain metals. Though platinum is suited for this, but since it is very costly, that's why it is made up of nickel. And these are porous, so when we supply hydrogen gas, due to the reaction taking place at this end, hydrogen emits electrons, and that is supplied for this load. Now the so working of this phosphoric acid fuel cell is similar to the alkaline fuel cell. The only difference lies in the electrolyte. In case of alkaline fuel cell, it was the aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, but in case of phosphoric acid fuel cell, it is phosphoric acid. And rest of the construction and operation remains the same. Here you can see one difference, that electrolyte should be supplied for cool, because large amount of heat is generated due to the electrochemical reaction which takes place inside the fuel cell, and that heat has to be taken out. So this electrolyte is taken for cooling purpose, and then again it is resupplied into this area. Okay, so supply of hydrogen, supply of oxygen, then removal of hydrogen vapor and spent fuel, that is spent gas. PAFC of phosphoric acid fuel cell consists of two electrodes of porous conducting material, that is nickel, to collect charge with concentrated phosphoric acid filled between them, which acts as electrolyte. Pure hydrogen or hydrogen rich gas is supplied at the negative electrode, and oxygen or ambient air is supplied at the positive electrode. So if you see this figure, this is negative electrode, hydrogen is supplied here. This is called negative because hydrogen emits hydrogen due to the electrochemical reaction. Electrons are removed from the hydrogen that is supplied to this load. That's why it is written negative. And oxygen supplied at the positive electrode. The pores provide an opportunity for gas, electrolyte, and electrode to come in contact for electrochemical reaction. Okay, these two electrodes are porous. So from this side, hydrogen gas, this electrode material, and this electrolyte will come in contact, and electrochemical reaction will take place. And due to that, electrons are emitted from the hydrogen, and positive ions move from hydroxyl ion moves from to this side. Similarly, from this side, oxygen also comes in contact with the this porous material, nickel electrode, and oxygen reacts with the hydroxyl ions, which are emitted by this electrochemical reaction taking place at this negative terminal, and water is made, H2O, that is water is made. Since due to this chemical reaction taking place inside the fuel cell, some heat is also generated. That's why H2O steam and bat steam or H2O vapor is generated. Okay. So there is some issue with this slide. Okay, now it is good. The pores provide an opportunity for gas, electrolyte, and electrode to come in contact for electrochemical reactions. The reaction is slow, and a catalyst is required in the electrode to accelerate the reaction. So, ideal catalyst is platinum, but since its cost is very high, that's why nickel is chosen. Some metal is chosen, so that is nickel. Platinum acts as best catalyst for both the electrodes. For economic reasons, nickel is used as catalyst for negative electrode and silver for positive electrode. Okay. Due to the usage of the cell, catalyst loses its activity, which is termed as poisoning of the catalyst. So, if we come across this word poisoning of the fuel cell, then this is the meaning of poisoning, because catalyst loses its activity, and due to catalyst, this electrochemical reaction takes place at faster rate. That means if we use catalyst properly, then a large amount of current will be generated. On the other hand, if we do not use catalyst, then magnitude of the current will be low. At the negative electrode, hydrogen is converted to hydrogen ions and equal number of electrons. So electron moves through this negative terminal through the load and generate electricity. And these hydrogen ions, positive ions, move to the positive terminal. It reacts with the oxygen and make the H2O. PAFCs are less efficient at generating electricity alone. That means if we want to use PAFCs for generation of the electricity only, then its efficiency could be ranging from 37% to 42%. PAFC efficiency is only slightly more than that of combustion-based power plants. Combustion-based power plants, that means thermal power plants, which typically operates an efficiency around 33%. PAFCs are also less powerful than other fuel cells, given the same weight and same volume. That means if we construct a fuel cell, one fuel cell that is PFC and the fuel cell that is alkaline of the same size, then it has the smaller efficiency, less powerful. Okay. As a result, these fuel cells are typically large and heavy. So, on the other hand, if we want to produce large amount of power using phosphoric acid fuel cell, then its size would be increased. Size means the size of overall size of the fuel cell. PFCs are also expensive. They require much higher loadings of expensive platinum catalysts than other types of fuel cells do. PFC is typically used for stationary power generation, but some PFCs have been used for powering city buses, that means automobiles also. So this is the brief description about phosphoric acid fuel cell. So if you go through the description of alkaline fuel cell or PFC, then you can see that operation of these two kinds of fuel cells are similar. There lies the difference in construction. There lies the difference in electrolyte used. So some reactions which takes place inside the fuel cell will be different, and different amount of electricity flows through the load here. Okay. And there is not much difference. Okay, so now description of these two types of fuel cells is over. If you have any doubt, you can unmute yourself and ask the question. आप में से यदि किसी को कोई doubt लगता है, तो unmute करके question पूछ सकते हैं. Otherwise अपन आगे चलते हैं. Okay, no issue. So now you can see fuel cell power plant. So this is a line diagram which shows electrical power generation scheme using fuel cell. Here you can see fuel processing. Actually, in a fuel cell, hydrogen is needed. Hydrogen or hydrogen this gas is needed, which acts as fuel in a fuel cell. So fuel processing unit is necessary that supplies the hydrogen. We have seen that hydrogen can be made in three different ways. It can be made from a reformation of this fuel cell, fossil fuel, can be generated from electrothermal reaction of the water. It can be generated from electrolysis of the water. But electrothermal and electrolysis of water produces less amount of heat, that means hydrogen. And it is the fossil fuel which is used largely for making hydrogen. When we are studying or discussing hydrogen, in that case, I told you that in US, around 95% of the hydrogen generated is generated by the from the fossil fuel. That's why it is written over here. So when a fuel processing unit necessary, which supplies necessary amount of hydrogen to the fuel cell, and oxygen or ambient air can also be used as oxidizer in the fuel cell. So here you can see air. So hydrogen from this side, which acts as fuel, is supplied through this fuel processing unit to the fuel cell modules, and ambient air is also supplied as an oxidizer to the fuel cell module. Now, what is the module? Here we stack large number of fuel cell one over other, and it is known as a module. I will show you the figure later on. So a number of fuel cells are connected in series, where we supply hydrogen or hydrogen with gas as fuel, and oxygen or air, ambient air, as oxidizer. Through this, due to the electrochemical action taking place inside the fuel cell module, electricity is generated, which is DC type. It is supplied to the electric power conditioner, where we use inverter for conversion of this DC power into AC. Conditioning is also needed, and then through the switchgear, it is supplied either to the grid or for the use. So there is a control unit which controls the amount of fuel which has to be supplied to the fuel cell module. It is also connected to the fuel cell module, and it overall controls the activity of all these four blocks: fuel processing unit, fuel cell module, electrical power conditioner, and switch current supply. Okay, so electrical energy generated from fossil fuel through a fuel cell, and that is through this hydrogen only. That means fossil fuel is converted into hydrogen, hydrogen supplied to the fuel cell, and electricity is generated. So this is the theory behind it. Fuel is supplied to a fuel processing unit. Fuel cell module converts fuel energy electrochemically into DC power using ambient air as an oxidant, and then it is supplied through this inverter. This DC is converted to AC. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you can unmute and ask the question. Otherwise, I move further. No question. Now in this figure, you can see the fuel cell module. Here you can see a stack of fuel cell. Okay. Where there are large number of electrodes, okay, electrolyte, separator, air passes, that means it acts as oxidizer, and fuel pass, fuel gas passes. ठीक है ना, यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हो उसको, यहाँ पे ऐसे भी देख सकते हो कि we are supplying air and fuel to all these are individual fuel cells, these are connected together in order to have large amount of electricity generated through these fuel cell module. So this is a one kind of module, and large number of modules are connected together in order to take large amount of electrical power from it. So number of fuel cells are stacked to form a power generating unit. Fuel gas and air are supplied to the module. So one common supply will be there for supplying fuel, that is hydrogen. Another common supply will be there for supplying oxidizer, that is ambient air can be used in this case also. The exhaust is collected in a common pipe and discharged to the atmosphere. What is exhaust in this case? So that is steam or water vapor, which is generated. Actually, we have already seen that due to the chemical reaction, electrochemical reaction taking place inside the fuel cell module, due to the reaction of hydroxyl ions with the oxygen, water is made, and due to the temperature of the fuel cell reaction, it is converted into steam. So the exhaust is supplied to the atmosphere. The power generating unit generates electrical power as DC, as we discussed in the previous unit. From this fuel cell module, DC power is generated. The electrical power conditioning unit converts DC output of fuel cell to AC using inverter, and also controls and regulates it. So this is the overall theory behind it. So now if the question arises or question comes into the examination that you have to explain a fuel cell power plant, then these two kind of diagram will be sufficient. You can draw this line diagram also. This will be and you can elaborate it also. Okay. So this was a brief description about fuel cell power plant. We have discussed in this lecture alkaline fuel cell, phosphoric acid fuel cell. So working of different kind of fuel cells remains the same. The only difference lies in the electrode material and the electrolyte. Electrolyte is of course different in all different kinds of fuel cells. Due to the availability of the fuel, which is either pure hydrogen, hydrogen is gas or some other gas, and due to the availability of the oxidizer, which is either pure oxygen or ambient air, and due to this electrolytic reaction, electrolyte used inside the fuel cell and the reaction taking place inside the fuel cell between gas, that is fuel, hydrogen, electrode and electrolyte, different kind of electricity. So from my side, lecture is over. Now if you have any doubt, you can unmute yourself and ask the question. आपको कहीं पे भी कोई डाउट आ रहा तो आप अनम्यूट करके क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं. ओके, नो क्वेश्चन.